pleasure being here, as it always is. I remember, actually many, many years ago, being here on another panel before I was even an elected official. But for those of you who don't know me, my name is Roxanne Qualls, and I am running for City Council. I decided to come back into public service in 2007 because I want to use my experience, first as a community organizer, which I was at one time, later as a director of two community-based organizations, then as a council member and as mayor, and after I left office in 2000, as a student and teacher of public policy, to address some of the critical issues we're facing as a city. I also want to use that experience because it gives me a certain amount of perspective on both the issues that the city is confronting, as well as an ability and willingness to take on some of the city's tougher issues. We all talk about how it's necessary to improve the quality of life in our neighborhoods, support economic development, as well as responsibly manage the budget. But that has to translate into being willing to take on some risks. And so when it comes to improving the quality of life in our neighborhoods and for the people, one of the things which I took on early on was a thing called the Homeless with Homes Initiative. And the objective of that was, for the first time ever in the city of Cincinnati, to actually develop a system for single homeless men and women that could potentially become a national model. The great news is that we're seeing success. We now know that in fact, next week, the first ever shelter for youth will open on Highland Avenue. Within a year, hopefully within 6 months, we will break ground on Reading Road for the first ever women's shelter in the city of Cincinnati. City Gospel Mission is moving to landscape and expanding, as well as integrating its services. And the Drop-In Center, which can't be ignored, has actually made some radical changes to its service provision and is looking at sites that will actually accommodate both its clientele as well as the types of service it needs to provide. In addition to that, I've worked with a variety of neighborhoods on specific projects ranging from the Collegeville Business District to Madisonville with their business district improvements, as well as the issue we're currently confronting regarding what we know as the Red Bank Expressway and their desire to ensure that they don't have an expressway through their neighborhood, but that any improvements actually enhance the vitality and vibrancy of their community. When it comes to economic development, I have particularly focused on investments in major transportation projects, leading the effort on City Council to ensure that the $3.5 billion invested in what's known as the Brent Spence Bridge Project actually is leveraged so that we can see businesses and jobs created in that corridor. We can make sure there's the type of transportation connections that are necessary, and ultimately to ensure that whatever we do not only doesn't contribute but happens to solve what are our major stormwater issues that are costing MSD ratepayers a lot of money now and will also in the future. The budget, the good news about the budget is that we are no longer at a $33 million deficit. We are now officially, as of 2 weeks ago, down to about $20 million. And with revisions to projections of income tax being received, as well as some alterations to the cutbacks that the state was anticipating doing, we are probably more in the range of about somewhere between 15 and 18. That's the good news and the bad news. If there are no layoffs, if there are no increases in revenues, then the only thing we will be able to do this year with the budget, unless we use and confine one-time resources, is to continue cutting non-safety departments, which we have been doing since 2000. And I'm happy to talk about that during the question and answer period.